The art of photography began in the early 1800s. Today, we take photography for granted. But if it weren't for quantum effects of photons on atoms and chemical bonds, there would be no pictures. This antique view camera may look like a relic, but it works on the same principles as modern cameras. The lens refracts the light reflected from the scene, forming a sharp image on this ground glass. To take a picture, close the shutter and insert the film holder in front of the ground glass. By opening and closing the shutter, a certain number of photons reach the film where they interact with the electrons involved in chemical bonds. So in order to understand how photography works, we'll need to explore chemical bonds.
Pure potassium is not very stable. It dulls quickly because it oxidizes with air and it reacts violently in water. For potassium to reach a stable electron configuration, it must bond with other atoms.
Atoms gain or lose electrons to become chemically stable. But according to the law of conservation of mass, matter cannot be created or destroyed in a chemical reaction. Where do these electrons come from and where do they go? To reach a stable configuration, elements share or transfer valence electrons from other atoms. This interaction between atoms is referred to as chemical bonds.
All atoms joined by chemical bonds form compounds. Copper 2 sulfate, for example, is joined by the bonding of copper, sulfur, and oxygen atoms.
For hydrogen atoms to achieve a stable electron configuration, they must gain an electron to complete the first energy level. By forming a nonpolar covalent bond with another hydrogen atom, each atom shares its electron and reaches a stable configuration.
Where are the shared electrons placed? Remember that in the quantum mechanical model of an atom, no definite boundaries exist for atoms. There are only probability distributions that represent an electron's probable location. Here is the probability distribution for a hydrogen molecule. Where would the bonding electrons in this molecule most likely be found? There is an equal chance that the electrons will be found near either atom. Recall, they share electrons equally. However, there is a higher probability that the bonding electrons for these atoms will be found between the two nuclei.
When the nucleus of one atom pulls harder than another atom on a shared electron, the bond is called polar covalent. Hydrogen chloride has a polar covalent bond. A polar bond is similar to a magnet. It has oppositely charged poles. This is called a dipole.
The positive pole, represented by a lowercase delta with a positive sign, is the end of the molecule that is slightly more positive on average, because the valence electrons in a polar covalent bond are less likely to be found there. The negative pole, represented by a lowercase delta with a negative sign, is the end of the molecule that is slightly more negative on average, because the valence electrons in a polar covalent bond are more likely to be found there.
One way to test the charge distribution of polar bonds is to place a sample in an electric field. How will hydrogen chloride align itself? The negative ends of the molecules will position themselves towards the positive pole of the electric field, and the positive ends of the bond toward the negative ends. Remember, opposite charges attract.
An ionic bond occurs when one atom attracts another atom's electron so strongly that it actually pulls one or more electrons from that other atom. When an atom gains or loses an electron, it becomes an ion. Ions of opposite charge attract each other and form ionic bonds. Calcium reacts with oxygen to form calcium oxide, an ionic compound. What are the charges of the oxygen and calcium ions? Calcium loses 2 electrons, giving it a charge of positive 2. The oxygen ion has a charge of negative 2 because it gains 2 electrons. These opposite charges attract, holding the ions together in a crystal.